Hello, let's explore knowledge representation. Knowledge representation is defined as the method used to encode knowledge in an expert system's knowledge base. The objective is to express the acquired knowledge in computer tractable form so that it can help expert systems in making decisions. There are several techniques to represent knowledge. Today, we will go through these five types: object attribute value, logical representation, semantic networks, frames, and production rules. Object attribute value is a simple way to store facts. Each fact about a group of objects is set out systematically in columns. For example, in this table, you can see that each row belongs to one object and each column has the fact or attributes about the objects. There is little opportunity for inference. Logical representation, on the other hand, represents knowledge using mathematical or orthographic symbols, inference rules, and are based on precisely defined syntax and semantics. This can be in the form of predicate logic, first-order logic, proportional logic, and higher-order logic. A more common technique of knowledge representation is semantic network. Semantic network is a formal graphic language representing facts about entities about which we could perform reasoning. It shows hierarchical relationships between objects using nodes and arcs. The nodes represent objects and the arcs represent the relationships between objects. The two common arcs used are is a, used to show class relationship, and has a, used to identify characteristics or attributes of the object nodes. Other arcs are used for definitional purpose only. There are various types of semantic networks. First is an or tree. In this example, the tree is to find a way to it. Normal arc means or, but an arc with a curve means an. There are three options, which are to earn money, steal food, or borrow money. To earn money, you can either find a job or write a book. To borrow money, you need to call bank and put on a suit. There is also an is a hierarchy semantic network. In this hierarchy, you can see that an object is a type of another object. For example, a cat is a pet, which is an animal and is a living thing. There's also an is-part hierarchy that shows an object is a part of another object. A semantic network can also be used to represent events and language. In this example, you can see that John gave week 6 lecture to his students. Week 6 is an object of event 107. Finally, a typical semantic network can be in the form of a mixed type whereby different types of networks are combined. Another way to represent knowledge is by using frames. It is an alternative way to structure and organize knowledge. Each frame has a name and slots which can be filled by values or procedures for calculating values or pointers to another frame. This example here has two frames. The first describes a hotel room, while the other describes a hotel chair. You can see that the hotel room frame points to the hotel chair frame, showing relationship between them. Finally, we can represent knowledge using production rules, which I believe most are familiar with. It is based on the general underlying idea of condition-action pairs, also called if-then pairs, production rules, or just plain productions. It is written in the form of, if this condition holds, then this action is appropriate. In this example, there are four rules. The top part is called antecedent or conditions, while the lower part is the consequent or conclusion. If the condition is true, then the conclusion holds. When developing a knowledge base for an expert system, production rules is the most common technique. A knowledge base is also known as production memory. In rule-based expert systems, the inference engine determines which rule antecedents are satisfied by the facts before executing a conclusion. We will learn more about this later. For now, thanks for watching!